Myself, Atul Arora, Assistant Professor, Department of Law, SV College, Aligarh. Today, I am going to deliver a lecture on the most important topic of the most important subject, that is the preamble of the Constitution of India. We all know that Constitution is the mother of all the laws, and preamble is the most important topic of this Constitution. So, here the preamble is written on the board. Each and every word of the preamble is very carefully chosen, so we cannot change, alter, or even the change the sequence of any word in the preamble. So everyone should learn this, learn by heart. Ratta maar lena chahiye iska. We the people of India. Theek hai? So now I am starting the main words to define that what is the meaning of each and every word, because every word is very important. I can classify the preamble into 5 kinds. First of all, if I am giving the name of this first, the source of the preamble of the Constitution, that is the we the people of India. Sovereignty lies in the people of India. Because the people are sovereign, that's why the India is sovereign. We the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic. We cannot even change the sequence of these words. These 4 or 5 are the nature of the Constitution. I can define the nature of the Constitution. First of all, we are sovereign. What do you mean by the sovereign? Sovereign means internally and externally. We are free. We are free to decide even the internal management of the country. The government is free to make laws to serve the country, to serve the people, and even the also the external. Socialist means there should be no discrimination according to the social discrimination, that may be religion, race, caste, sex, place of birth, or any other reason. That should be a social factor. Third, we are secular. Secular means the state has no particular religion. Every citizen has free to choose his own religion. He can change religion, he can follow, propagate religion of his own choice. The state will secure every religion by equal weightage. Fourth, democratic. Democracy means to the people, by the people, for the people. Because India is a democratic country means there is no hierarchy. There is no PM, there is no president of, last PM or president, no succession. We choose either directly or indirectly, but we choose. Like president of India is elected by the people indirectly for 5 years. Republic. Republic is a short form of representation of people. Means we are choosing a head of the state by election and he will represent the public, means people of the India. And to secure to all its citizens justice, liberty, equality and fraternity. These 4 are, I can named as objectives. These are the objectives enshrined in the preamble, which are embodied in fundamental rights, in DPSP, fundamental duties, and all the other relevant chapters of the Constitution. Here are 3 types of justice: social, economic, and political. There are 4 types of liberty: thought, expression, belief, faith, and worship. The third objective is equality, equality of both status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and unity and integrity of the nation. Fraternity means brotherhood. So, bandhutva ki bhavna ko badhane ke liye hai, individual ki dignity, aur ye aage fundamental rights mein aur DPSP mein alag alag provisions mein mention kiya gaya hai. Fourth point, in our constituent assembly this day of 26th of November 1949, this is the date of acceptance of the preamble. We have accepted on this day. That's why we also celebrate this day as the Constitution Day in India. Do hereby adopt, enact, and give to ourselves this Constitution. This is the fifth point that we are adopting this. This will connect with the we the people of India. No one is imposing preamble on us. Just we are adopting, we are enacting, we are giving to ourselves this Constitution. Now there is a most important question, that preamble is a part of the Constitution or not. There was a dispute regarding this. First of all, in 1960, in the case of Ribeiro Barri, the Supreme Court has held that preamble is not a part of the constitution. And this is a very question of common sense, that when any provision is not a part of the subject, then there cannot be amendment for that. So there was situation before 1960 World II that preamble is not a part of the constitution and therefore it cannot be amended. But in later 1973, there was a very important case of Keshavanand Bharathi versus State of Kerala. The Supreme Court has overruled its own old ruling and held that preamble is a part of the constitution, and when it is part, again that common sense that it can be amended. After, there are a lot of cases, for example LIC case, in which the Supreme Court has held that this is an integral part of the constitution. So I have mentioned here that it can be amended also. So there are two amendments, one amendment, but there are two places where words have been amended. First of all, socialist and secular have been amended, and integrity, unity and integrity has been added, this word. There was no present these two words and these two words in the old preamble, but by the 42nd Amendment Act 1976, these words socialist and secular and integrity, they have been inserted by the 42nd Amendment Act in 1976. Thank you.